This is like a big question, but what would you say is the goal of your art?
I want to respond to this question with a very existential kind of argument that I personally don't think that there's anything outside of people that can tell people what to do. Do people look at the camera at it in the documentary?
I guess look at me.
I could look at you, but wouldn't that be... Yeah, I guess it would be kind of weird if I was looking right at the camera.
I think it would.
I'm Maxwell Schenkel. Everyone calls me Max. And I do neuroscience and studio art at Boston College. There's an interesting reciprocal relationship between my academic work and how I develop as an artist. I went from biology, which is very cut and dry in many aspects. When you transition into neuroscience, having the psychological element kind of allows me to discover myself in a new way. I had set up so many boundaries within my own mind, and art kind of was able to wash a lot of that preconception away and allow me to bring out my full potential, I think.
You get in the computer case?
Yeah.
I got you.
And mix out a little water. Why are you doing that?
Just for the visual. I know, and I also like to mix it to get it a good consistency because this stuff is really, really, really dark.
Yeah.
I've been noticing recently that a lot of the abstract work I've been doing has kind of been paralleled with the things that I've been studying in my developmental neuroscience class. So there's like a lot of analogous aesthetics to like cellular machinery and like neurons and like tubes and all like connections and stuff like that. Some people are very regimented in their artwork. I don't necessarily think you have to do that. I work more in bursts, but the problem there is being that, what if you have a really long time where, like, you don't have ideas and you don't want to work? And I think we're kind of conditioned to believe that work sucks. Being an adult sucks. So part of getting old is life sucking. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, that's such a misdirection. I don't think that. Art helps me kind of, like, remember that that's not the case. This is fun.
Definitely.
This is my own little world in here, you know, like, it is an escape of freedom.
Yeah, I'm looking at my zodiac sign, and all the constellations changing every time, but I'm in my mind, this is like a world, this is like a matrix, my imagination, it is fucking changing, every picture, it's like a painting, every time, yeah, it's like...
I think music is a big part of my process, like, I sing, and I rap, and I write songs, but I would say that the visual arts are definitely my forte.
And I can see the vision. It's like a
one, two, three, four.
In our last interview in the studio when I was painting that skull, given the context, given the fact that I was talking to someone, there was kind of a serene, calm environment. It felt as if that short amount of time that I was working on it kind of extended out and it became more of a meditative experience.
Sometimes the art-making process can be extremely frantic, where it almost feels stressful, that if I don't get all the ideas out, then I'm going to lose them, and then I'm not going to be able to recover them again. The kind of art that I was making during that multiple-month period of COVID was distinctly different than the kind of art that I'm making now. The art then was almost driven by a need to survive. Even going into COVID, my family situation on many fronts was kind of chaotic and hard to grasp at the time. And then there was so much isolation, both physically, emotionally, psychologically. There was an order I was trying to distill from that chaos. And the aesthetic of many of those pieces reflects that internal turmoil and struggle to make sense of seemingly disparate elements of my life. A lot of it was deeply meditative, deeply surreal, sometimes dark, chaotic, and tragic. But during the process of it, I felt like I was getting things out that would have hurt me if I had internalized them. You living in this space, yeah, but you ain't find your purpose. You feeling like you're nervous and you feeling like the color purple. You looking at the... It's the same reason why abstract art developed in response to World War I. How do you depict the tragedy and chaos and brutality of a world war using romantic or Renaissance art? That would be so idealized that it would probably disgust people. Yeah. They needed to use fictive characters and categories in order to really be more real than reality ever could be. And when you fall like a domino, this chaos theory, this quantum physics step inside my head, I see the queries, and they're asking me this question. Yeah, the end is nearing, and yeah, I'm fearing all the demons deep inside their soul, and yeah, they're feeling like they're getting old, their blood is slow. You have the opportunity to work in this field until you're very old, so you need to be open to the idea that you can change and grow over that whole period. The idea that after you're done in art school, then you're done training, that's going to prevent you from ever becoming your best self. And maybe there is no best self that you can reach, because even at the end of your life, there's always, if you lived another year, maybe you could have been better. And that's not a bad thing, because that means you can never truly be finished growing. You gotta throw a little oscillation in the mix to make that life go up and down. Whether that's positive or negative, you gotta fucking... You gotta shake shit up, you know what I mean? Like, we weren't born to just, like, perpetuate the status quo. Like, if you wanna live a good life, I feel like you gotta shake shit up. I mean, that's me, you know what I mean? Like, I can't tell other people to live like that, but, like, that's just, like, that's what I wanna do. Then you see the fucking...